Ducks coach Randy Carlisle said ahead of the Ducks hosting the Oilers Wednesday that this is the biggest game of the year for both teams. It's that simple. Both teams start the day with 87 points and tied for second in the Pacific with 10 games left. Jonathan Bernier has picked up the slack for the injured John Gibson, making his 11th straight starting goal with a 7-2-1 record over that span.
From Cogliano. Oh! The red line went out. I think it went off the post. He went against the grain, and he had Talbot all the way outside of the crease.
He had a wide open net, and unfortunately,
scores at the other end. So often the case, a glorious chance at one end. The other team goes down and scores.
That most teams feel they can get to Talbot with. Put pucks into his feet and then crash the net. Those rebounds up top.
Eaves with a nice feed. Scores! And somehow that one fooled Talbot. Five-hole, brand new game.
This is not a pretty goal that Cam Talbot gives up.
And Anaheim able to clear as Silverberg was roughed up right at the stripe. Here's McDavid, takes the stretch, tries to cut to the middle, does, and he scores!
Stretch pass, McDavid's got it, but watch how he gets the shoulder inside, and then it's all about the reach.
He's able to clear the zone, and now Lindholm circles back with him. Lindholm now tied for eighth amongst defensemen and assists in Ducks history. Great pass in front to Lindholm, who finishes the feed from Rakell, and the Ducks have tied it again. Maroon out of the corner, trying to sneak it in front as Klefbom wanted to knife right down the center lane, but broken up and brought back by Manson. Josh Manson right down the middle, pulls it in and scores!
He rushes the puck right up the middle of the ice, and at the very last second, he's just going to say, well, if they're going to back up and back up, I might as well fire it.
Trying to find some space, and when you think about Edmonton and their speed, you got to think 4-on-4 works their way, but it's Anaheim 3-on-2 the other way. Rakell cuts into the middle, and his shot disrupted by Russell, gets it back, and scores! Rickard Rakell at his finest!
He works it around Russell, and he just snaps it over the glove.
Curls to stay on the forehand, Getzlaf touches it across, Fowler's one-timer, hit the post, Silverberg!
Anaheim comes so close to expanding their lead. Sometimes it is better to be lucky than good.
Protecting the line, Silverberg does a nice job protecting the puck, Kessler and Klefbom go after a loose puck and it bounces free. Here comes Mark Letestu, shorthanded, joined by Cashman. Got it over to him. Point blank save, Bernier.
What a stop. Remember that one. That was a big stop by Jonathan Bernier.
On top, 4-2, Anaheim has been very good in this circumstance this year. 27-2-1 when leading after two. And wow, Brossois forced to make a point blank save on Eve to begin the period.
Yeah, his best stop before making their play on the net.
McDavid races ahead. Maroon gives it back to him. 10 seconds left. Connor McDavid from behind the net, right through the crease. Letestu scores. Only 6.7 remains. He's going to challenge whether the play was offside.
Yeah, they're looking at Pat Maroon, and does he lift up that back foot before that puck crosses the line? I tell you what, that's close.
Close, yeah.
Call on the ice stands. We have a good goal. There will be 8.0 seconds on the clock.
The Ducks did not make it easy on themselves, but they do hang on to defeat the Oilers 4-3 at the Honda Center. They take over sole possession of second place in the Pacific. Hampus Lindholm, a goal and two assists for his first career three-point game. Ryan Getzlaf, a three-point night, all on assists. The Ducks had more chances to add on, but went 0-5 on the power play. Jonathan Bernier was solid, totaling 29 saves.